Hello, I'm Mr. Ardinger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist, and I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. So I'm open-minded, and in open mind, you learn a lot. That was St. Paul said, listen to everyone, and vet them in Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. We call it Surti in Punjabi. So many people don't have common sense. They go by the dead letters. And the dead letters, they end up like the Jerusalem theologians who wanted to kill Jesus. Whereas the good news of the birth of Jesus with Christ in his heart was broken to the shepherd, illiterate shepherd in the field tending their sheep very tentatively or very devotedly. So, gospel is for the new skin capable of holding the new wine, which are the illiterate people who have childlike heart that Jesus created at Cana. When the old wine finished and they desiring new one, they were not satisfied with the old, they wanted more. And then Jesus asked the laborer to rinse out all the specks of the old wine from those vats, create a new skin. And then he put water in it, making it neutral, like a little child who haven't been to the school or anything like that. But gospel is for people who are 20 to 30 years old, and not for the little child. But it was given an example that unless you become like little children, you cannot have gospel. So gospel is delivered to the illiterate people, new skin, and not to the university professors of theology who ply dead letters, so much so dead letters that I went to Oxford University Pusey House chapel, and over there they had three candles on this side, three candles on the other side. And in the middle, they put the icon of Jesus, which was a metal one. So I asked those students or people who are worshipping, why there are three candles here, three candles there? They have no idea, first of all. Then I told the priest over there that this is a menorah, and the middle candle is missing. Where the middle candle? Oh, middle candle of Christ. Oh, that icon over there, idol. Can you light a lamp with idol? The middle candle is first lit, is ever lit by the other six candles. They are lit from the middle candle. The middle candle of the menorah is for God. So unless you get light from God, our soul, you cannot be living, you will be dead. So here it is, the situation. So here is the three candle here, three candle here. This is of creation of Yahweh. Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, same thing. Demiurge, potter, they created these pots. And the middle candle is of Elohim, which is stand for light, or Noor, Allah. Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM, same thing. So this is the Noor. So this is the, in the beginning was the Word, and this is the Word. And Word became flesh in the name of Christ Jesus, in Jesus. So this light of God then make the other candles living, people living, social, ecumenical, political affair. Social, ecumenical, political affair. One side is holy, other side is evil. So all of them have the same soul as of our supernatural father. So when the soul is of our supernatural father, if you hit somebody, you are hitting the soul of the person. He is a flesh, cannot feel anything. It is the soul that feels the pinch. And then we are hurting our brother, because we are one father, we are all brethren, whether you are good or bad. So that's why in Jesus, when somebody hit you, you present the other cheek. You have to hit the conscience of the person. But these people, Messianic Jews, after the death of apostles, and the church was formed, in which people sold all their worldly possessions to enter that fold. Ananias and Sapphira, they sold their possession, but they kept back money. One finger in God and one finger in mammon they wanted. You cannot love God and mammon at the same time. You will love one and hate the other. So like Judas Iscariot, he loved money, mammon, and he hated the other people, and he was misguiding them or dissuading them. But the other people were convinced, and they were not affected by his dissuasion. So that's why at the Last Supper, Judas Iscariot threw him out, because he was a thief. Thief stealing money from the church purse, as today the dog collar people steal money from the church purse. In the eyes of the people, they can justify what they are doing, but not in God. As St. Paul said, you know that he worked as a tent maker to earn his living. He said he never took money out of the church. He gave to the church and not take money out of the church. Because what applied to flesh under Judaism, you pay tithe. Under spirit, you don't pay tithe. You help the people, yourself, because you are the royal priest. You don't need anybody to. You give money to him and he will chop your money away, or he will finish with stealing your money. So you do the philanthropic work yourself and not give it to money to anyone else. So these hireling dog collar priests in the churches, first of all they are working for mammon, and then they are bound by the church laws that you can't do this thing, you can't do that thing. They are not free men. They are the hireling of mammon. And how can they preach the gospel of God? No way. They will hate it. As the temple priest hated Christ Jesus, that hatred was not so much as today. The proper people hate those who come in the name of Christ Jesus. So I went to Oxford University, and over there was a seminar which was Jewish and Christians seminar for 2 days. I was a bit late, and when I got my badge and everything, I was sitting in the room listening to the first lecture. When it finished, then a lady at the door, called me, come, come. So I went there to see her, and she told me, oh, you can't sit in this room with this hoodie on. What is written on the hoodie, people don't like, students don't like it. And this is the light on the living lampstand, I'm the lampstand, and this is the light. And she, I told her, it's a living light on the living lampstand, but she won't understand it. She was determined to throw me out because I'm a Gnostic. Gnostic are, they proclaim it heretic because they can't understand the language, spiritual language of God. And they take everything literal. So much so, the Samaritan woman at the well, her five husbands are well known in India. When the second coming of Jesus took place, and they are immorality, anger, greed, worldly attraction, and haughtiness. They are the five husbands. Spiritual, which all of them she has overpowered. The last husband living with her, but not her husband, was haughtiness of spiritual knowledge. With the university professors, you will see them. I don't have a degree in theology. And at Keble College, I used to attend their New Testament seminar. And I told them that we have a demiurge God, Potter, and we are the real one, too. No, we are only one God. And then they sent me a letter by email that you can't come to attend these seminars unless you have an MA or PhD degree in theology, or you get a recommendation from a local priest to come and attend. So these people, they are Antichrist because they are the hireling, like the centurion who was a hireling of Roman. And he told Jesus that I'm not worthy to let you come under my roof, because I myself is a slave to the Roman. I'm not a free man. So these people, docile people, they are nowhere near the free man. They are slaves to Mammon, slaves to the church elders, or the what is written constitution. They are bound by law. In Jesus we are not bound by law. We are free. My Holy Spirit has set us free. So they have no knowledge of such freedom. They happily get money at the end of the month, and they are very happy. They will speak sugar-coated sermon to attract more customers. So more money they can get from the church. So wake up. Gospel is for the one in 1,000 and two in 10,000. You need to be solitary. Solitary person is free of the elders or the church, these law and other things. Constitution, this and that, you know. So you need to be free man to preach gospel. Then you can preach what you have understood from Christ Jesus. That's why Jesus said, after feeding the 5,000, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus, what came out of the mouth of Jesus, this is the ear to eat it with your ears. Take it to your heart, digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning, and understand it thoroughly. And then with authority, preach gospel to the other through logical reasoning. And that will brew logo. And that is called drinking the blood of Christ. Now, this recently, this Holocaust people are having prayer and all that, you know. During the Holocaust, not a single Jew died. Because Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual, not outwardly tribal. This is tribal self. This is spiritual self. In Abraham, he was of Semitic race. He was the ideal Adam who was brought from the Iraq area to come and settle there as ideal Adam, Sarah as Eve, and they were given by Yahweh, Khuda or Brahma, in land, which is the Garden of Eden. So far they were faithful to Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. They were eating best quality food in the world. But as soon as they become unfaithful to Brahma, unfaithful to Yahweh, the same land will become barren, making them to rotate it. Because a person who is not faithful to you, you will throw him out of the house or cut him off your family tree. So such a person, when they are unfaithful, Abraham, unfaithful Yahweh, as the people of Isaac are, prodigal son, father had two sons, elder one is Ishmael, the younger one is Isaac, and father is Abraham. Then the younger one said, give me my share, I want to leave, share me. That what belonged to him, he wanted to get away from the father. And the father, he had the protection and was well fed, as people in Africa and Brazilian jungle, they are well fed. They lack nothing. And people in the towns and other places where Mammon dominates, oh, they lack everything. And they get hurricanes and all that. Whereas the Brazilian jungle people, they are protected by Yahweh. They don't get any hurricane. They live in straw huts. And they are not destroyed by strong wind or anything. So, America and other thing, you get strong wind, typhoon, destroying the houses and other things. They don't suffer, because they are protected by their Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, our Heavenly Father, and nobody can touch. Now, coming to the point, Jesus' language is scriptural, and in spirit he said, unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Now, these theologians of the dead letters, they haven't got the slightest clue to this parable. And they always think man to be like this one, with the beard and turban and all that, are with genital organs, and female different, with genital organs, no beard or moustache. And they take everything what they see with the naked eye. They are incapable of perceiving. Because on perceiving, they will be having controversy. Some people will say this and some people will say that. So they want to avoid controversy. And most of them are defining an elephant. Blind men defining an elephant. The elephant is like this and that. That is how the churches are divided. If there is somebody who is enlightened, whose eyes are not blind, he will see the whole element as one piece, one God, one faith. So Christ is the omnipotent ambassador of our supernatural Father sitting inside here, not in heaven anymore. So those people who say, our Father in heaven in prayer, they are Antichrist. They are spiritually blind that he is not sitting in heaven or anywhere. He is your tribal father with you. And the spiritual father is inside here, no more alienated like Yahweh in heaven. Yahweh is a potter. So on this basis, St. Thomas said, unless a female is one who, as in the house, the man is the master of the house, woman is mistress. So anything, responsibility falls on the man and not on the woman. Woman will do what the man will tell him to do. As Gamaliel was telling Saul, his disciple, what to do. And he was an obedient disciple. He will do what his master will tell him to do. So his master said, persecute the laborer of Jesus, and he was doing it. All of a sudden then, Christ Jesus came into his life and he opened his eyes through Damascus lightning experience. The thickness of the scale that came off from his eye is the thickness of the darkness the hireling Gamaliel was doing. And today these priests are much worse than those at the time of Christ Jesus, the temple priest. They were far better than today's priest. So, let's carry on. So, after the lightning experience, then Paul was solitary, no more under the domination of the temple priest, Gamaliel, or anyone else. And that is why in the Bible, Luke 16, verse 16, is stated, law and prophets were till John the Baptist, angel. Angels are the whip master for the priest to put them on the right path. So in this dark age, they say things as they like it to their own whims. To their own whims mean hireling priest, inch pope. Pope is Antichrist. You cannot give your account to God. So are the doppel priests in the churches. They are thieves of the order of Judah Iscariot. So they will only preach what their master tells them to preach. Sorry. The hireling, they only do what their master tells them to do, as Saul was doing what Gamaliel told him to do. But when they become independent, solitary, age around 20 plus, you know, So then they will start thinking themselves. It was those people who came to John the Baptist, and the temple priests were making them Jew outwardly. So it is those people who break off those people and listen to my brother. And they were Surti royal priest. Same with Christ Thomas to India. And over there he was preaching gospel. So the hate workers, they were not under the domination of St. Thomas. They were free men. And they were Christ and not Christian. I am a Christ. I'm not a Christian. Christ know what they say from their mouth. John 3, Nicodemus. But below they say what the book or the rabbis will tell them, or the university professor will tell them, this is right. So Saul, when he was the disciple of Gamaliel, he was a female. In flesh he was a male, but in spirit he was a female, because he was doing blindly what his blind master Gamaliel was telling him to do. But when he realized that what he is doing is wrong, then they went to John the Baptist to be baptized in water in the name of Abraham, and they became twice born disciples of John the Baptist. And those people who are looking forward to worship supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM, they went to Christ Jesus. So, sorry, feeling sleepy, you know. So, Saul was a female, because he did what his master Gamaliel told him to do. So, he can't enter into the royal kingdom of God, in which you have to be independent, solitary. Nothing to do with your, what this man said or that man said. What God said, you go by God, and you are taught by God from your heart and not from any book. You know, Bible is forbidden in the royal kingdom of God. So here you are, here the John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, making them tribal people, and that seed need to be buried in the soil, or the ego of the seed is destroyed and turned into plant, in which you will know the supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM. So if you then twice born, then you are independent, you are not dependent on anyone, no law book or anything. You go by Holy Spirit, which is inside you. So then you preach gospel with authority. Because you have grafted yourself to the true vine, which is Abraham, and Christ, sorry, true vine, Christ Jesus. You have to be first son of man before you become son of God. So by becoming Jew inwardly, not outwardly, they rebuild their covenant with Abraham and with Yahweh. They became the sons of the Most High. And for this inside your heart, you need to take a shower. Sleepy, sleepy, sleepy. So in Mount Athos, they took the sense literally that in Christ Jesus we are made sons of man, sorry, sons of God. And over there in Mount Athos, they will only allow the male to enter. The female, they won't allow them. Because they have different organs. Whereas those monks over there, they are all governed by law of the law of their monastery, that you can't do this and you can't do that. Hardly you will find anyone free over there. So they are themselves Antichrist, and they call the other people anti-Semitic. So the people living at present at Mount Athos.